Hey, this is Carrie from Soundproofist, and in a previous video, I said that I would test some Android-based decibel reader apps, because the apps that I use in these videos are always iPhone apps. So today I'm going to demo two noise apps on an Android tablet. There's a third app that I installed, and I'll show it to you, but I didn't test it for this video. That's because it would automatically start charging my credit card after 3 days of trial use. So the apps that we'll test today are Sound Meter and Sound Spectrum Analyzer. The third app is called Decibel X, and I'll show you their setup screen, but not the noise test. So here are some of the things that I look for in a decibel app. Obviously, the first one is accuracy. I'm going to compare these Android apps to an iPhone app and a handheld decibel reader in real time, and we'll see how close they get. The second thing I look for is an option to test DBC instead of just DBA. As far as I can tell, the Android apps that I used are DBA only. That means they cut off some of the higher and lower frequencies in the spectrum, and when you use DBC, there's more of a range. My third preference is to be able to generate a report. Otherwise, you have to watch the real-time feedback and write notes about the decibel peaks. It would be much easier to generate a detailed report, like you can with the NIOSH sound app or the decibel meter app on iPhone. One of the apps that I'll test today saves a brief summary of the data collected, but not the other one. And the fourth thing that I look for is the ability to view frequency measurements at the same time as decibel readings. This is super helpful when you want to identify the type of noise that's coming through, and it helps you to figure out how to address it. One of the apps that we'll test today can read frequency and decibels at the same time, and the other one doesn't. Ready? So the first app we'll test is a decibel reading app called Sound Meter, created by a company called KUXUN Technology, or KUCO Apps. It's free to use. So let's take a look at the settings. It gives you the option to save the audio files, which means it can generate a very basic report. And it shows you the file path. You can keep the screen on, that's helpful. You can set the decibel level when you want a warning to get issued, when it reaches a certain decibel level, for example, and the type of warning. I set my warning to 80 decibels. It's got a privacy policy, which you should read, but I'm not going to read that right now. It doesn't look like there's an option to choose between DBA or another method like DBC, so it's DBA by default. Okay, so now I'm going to play a series of noises, the same type of traffic noises and machine noises that I played in the decibel meter video for iPhone. In fact, I'm going to run decibel meter side by side with this app. Now, decibel meter is set to DBC. I'll also set up an inexpensive decibel reader, the BAFX3370, and it can measure only in DBA. So we've got some comparisons now. Here we go. So as you can see, the Sound Meter app on the Android is showing a decibel reading that's far below the decibel instrument on the left and lower than the decibel meter app on the iPhone on the right. You can attribute some differences on the iPhone because the app is measuring in DBC, not DBA, but the BAFX decibel reader and the Android app are both reading DBA, and they're very different. I trust the DBA reading on the BAFX, but this is also a cheap Android tablet, so it's possible that the mic is not as good as the other two devices. All right, let's move on to the next app, Sound Spectrum Analyzer, created by PC Mehanik. This app displays both the frequency and the decibels together. I don't think you can set it to measure DBC, so again, it's DBA. It does not generate a report, so you have to pay attention to it in real time. I'm just going to use this app in the most basic way to give you a quick overview. Let's take a look at the settings. On the main screen, you've got a signal button. And when you tap that, you've got a white noise by default, or sine wave, or square wave. You've got a peak hold button. When you toggle it on, it will freeze the peak readings on the bar chart, but continue taking real-time readings. So you can see the peak and the real-time together. And the RTA button stands for real-time analysis. If you don't turn it on, you won't see any readings. If you tap the tools icon, you can choose your input, the built-in microphone on the Android, an AUX, which I assume is a plug-in microphone, and Bluetooth. I'm just going to use the built-in microphone. There's a max value, which I set to 110 decibels, though I don't think any sounds that we generate for these tests will come anywhere near that. There's also a calibration setting, which I didn't edit. It has some buttons on the right side for channels, and I'm not sure what these do. I tried to set up the three channels to monitor the three signal types, but they all default to the same setting. Maybe they're for different input types. There's no user guide, though, so I can't verify. There's also a compare button, but I had nothing to compare to. Let's get on with the test. So here you can see that the app is taking a lot of measurements. The decibel readings are in digital format on the left-hand side and also in a solid bar on the left side of the bar chart. The main bar chart displays the frequency readings. Sometimes the decibel readings are pretty close to the BAFX decibel reader, and sometimes it's off by a few decibels. This could also be due to differences in response time between the devices. And of course, the iPhone is showing different decibel readings because it's recording DBC. The iPhone app and the Android both display frequency measurements, but the iPhone displays one overall frequency at any given point, and the Android app shows a range. I don't see an option to generate or save a report in the Sound Spectrum Analyzer, but that would be a great addition. And finally, I installed a third app, which I didn't use, but I'll show you the installation setup. It's called Decibel X by Skypaw Limited. So when you install it and launch it, you can choose your language, which is good. They offer a lot of languages. Then it asks for permission to record audio. I chose while using the app, and you immediately start seeing a decibel reading. But you're not done yet. Then you see a reference chart for different decibel levels and their real-world equivalents. Then you see a page about hearing protection, and it looks like they're using the NIOSH standard for their measurements, which is good, but you can also choose OSHA or something else. But then you reach a point where you get a button that says, try it for free. And when you tap it, you'll find that you can use it for free for 3 days, and then it starts an annual subscription for $33.99 per year. However, I didn't proceed because I use a different app on my iPhone already. If you're an Android user and you don't have an iPhone, you might want to go ahead. It's up to you. Paid subscribers for this app can generate reports, and it does read decibels and frequencies together. I don't know if it offers DBC or if it's only DBA. In summary, SoundMeter offers a decibel reader and a report, but no frequency readings, and the decibel readings looked inaccurate to me on my Android device when I compared it to two other devices. Sound Spectrum Analyzer offers real-time measurements of decibels and frequencies together, but it doesn't generate a report. Decibel X offers a real-time decibel reader, a frequency reader, and it generates reports, but it has an annual fee of about $34, and I was unable to fully test it. I hope you found this helpful, and I'll keep looking for more Android apps to test in other episodes. I'm new to Android, so it might take a while to find the ideal app. Let me know in the comments if you have any specific requests. And for more information on noise and acoustics, visit soundproofist.com.